Hello friends, in my last video, we had seen Pareto chart in very detail. Now it's time to learn another tool in the journey of 7 basic quality tools. In this video, we are going to see Fishbone Diagram. It is known as Fishbone Diagram because of its shape, similar to the side view of a fish skeleton. It is also called as Cause and Effect Diagram and Ishikawa Diagram. The effect is shown as a fish head facing to the right, with the causes extending to the left as fish bones, the ribs branch off the backbone for major causes with sub-branches for root causes and to the many levels as required. Ishikawa diagrams were popularized in the 1960s by Kaoru Ishikawa, who pioneered quality management processes in the Kawasaki shipyards, and in the process became one of the founding fathers of modern management. The basic concept was first used in 1920s and is considered one of the 7 basic tools of quality control. Mazda Motors famously used an Ishikawa diagram in the development of the Miata MX-5 sports car. The fishbone diagram identifies many possible causes for an effect or problem. It can be used to structure a brainstorming session. It immediately sorts ideas into useful categories. When to use a fishbone diagram? When identifying possible causes for a problem, especially when a team's thinking is not going towards a root cause. Root cause analysis is intended to reveal key relationships among various variables, and the possible causes provide additional insight into the process behavior. The causes emerged by analysis, often through brainstorming sessions, are grouped into categories on the main branches of the fishbone. To help structure the approach, the categories are often selected from one of the common models shown below, but may emerge as something unique to the application in a specific case. Each potential cause is traced back to find out the root cause, often using the VIVA analysis technique. Fishbone diagram procedure. Let's see first 6M for manufacturing industries. Materials required are flip chart or whiteboard and marking pens. Step 1. Agree on a problem statement, that is effect. Write it at the center right of the flip chart or whiteboard. Draw a box around it and draw a horizontal arrow running to it. Brainstorm the major categories of the causes for the problem. These are methods, machines, man or people, materials, measurement and environment. Step 3. Write the categories of causes as branches from the main arrow. Step 4. Brainstorm all the possible causes of the problem. Ask, why does this happen? As each idea is given, the facilitator writes it as a branch from the appropriate category. Causes can be written in several places if they are related to several categories. Step 5. Again ask, why does this happen? About each cause. Write sub-causes branching of the causes. Continue to ask why and generate deeper levels of causes. Layers of branches indicate causal relationships. Step 6. When the group runs out of ideas, focus attention to the places on the chart where ideas are very few. Now let's see the fishbone diagram examples in manufacturing. This fishbone diagram was drawn by manufacturing team to try to understand the sources of periodic iron contamination. The team used the 6 generic headings to prompt ideas. Layers of branches shows thinking about the causes of the problem. For example, under the heading machines, the idea materials of construction shows 4 kinds of equipment and then several specific machine numbers. Note down, some ideas appear in 2 different places. For example, calibration shows up under methods as a factor in the analytical procedure and also under measurement as a cause of the lab error. Iron tools can be considered as a methods problem when they're taking samples or a manpower problem with maintenance personnel. Fishbone diagram is very common tool used in product marketing as well as service industries, but with some changes. Let's see. The 8 P's used in the product marketing. In product marketing, M's are replaced by P. This common model for planning in product marketing is also used in root cause analysis. as categories for the Ishikawa diagram as product, price, promotion, place, process, people, physical evidence, and performance. The 8 P's are primarily used in product marketing. The next is 4S. This is used in the service industries. In service industries, M's are replaced by S. An alternative used for service industries uses 4 categories of possible causes: surroundings, suppliers, systems, and skills. Remaining procedure for fishbone diagram will remain same as that of the manufacturing example. You can use multiple combinations of above categories to find out the root cause depending on the situation and the area of problem. Now, create a fishbone diagram in Excel. As I explained, it is very easy to prepare a whiteboard or paper and can be used for analysis. You can also easily draw it in Excel. Excel template is also available on ASQ site for ready-made format of 6M analysis. Now, how to create a fishbone diagram in Minitab? Let's continue with the above example. To make it easy and avoid confusion, I'm just explaining a part of methods to be drawn in the Minitab. We can see in the cause and effect diagram, under methods, there are two major causes, that is analytical procedure and sampling. So I have written it under method column. In analytical procedure, there are two sub-causes, that is not followed and calibration. I have entered a new column by the name analytical procedure as major cause and listed sub-causes under it. Similar thing I have done for another major cause, that is sampling. Once we have entered the data in Minitab worksheet to draw the fishbone diagram, go to the stat, quality tools, and select the cause and effect option. Cause and effect diagram dialog box will be open. Add the effect and title in the dialog box for which we are preparing the cause and effect diagram. In the row of methods, select branch as in column and the cause as method from the available option at the left side. Once you have entered the causes, click on the sub option to add the sub causes. In the row of analytical procedure, select sub branch as in column, and in causes, select analytical procedures. Repeat the procedure for another main cause, that is sampling, from the available option at the left side. Then click OK. You will get the final results as the diagram. Please like the video if you have found it useful. Add your valuable comments and suggestions. Share this video with all your friends and families and subscribe my channel. I will share similar useful information with you which will help you to improve your knowledge and experience in the future. To get the notifications of new videos on my channel, please go to the YouTube settings, notifications, learn and apply, and click on the bell icon. And finally, thank you for watching.